Jean Baptiste Le Rond d'Alembert was a French mathematician, mechanician, physicist, philosopher, and music theorist. He was born on 16th November 1717 at Paris in France. Until 1759, he was also co-edited with Denis of the Encyclopedia. The following were the awards: Fellow of the Royal Society, Fellow of the Institut de France, and he is known for ratio test, fictitious force, virtual work, etc. D'Alembert's formula for obtaining solutions to the wave equation is named after him. The wave equation is sometimes referred to as D'Alembert's equation. The D'Alembert operator, which first arose in D'Alembert's analysis of vibrating string, plays an important role in modern theoretical physics. We shall now state and prove D'Alembert's ratio test. D'Alembert's ratio test says that if series un belongs to S plus, and if limit of un plus 1 by un as n tends to infinity is L, then series un converges if L is less than 1 and diverges if L is greater than 1, and the test fails if L is equals to 1. That is, the given series un is a series of positive terms. That is, every term of this given series is positive. And if the limit of the ratio un plus 1 and un as n tends infinity is L, then the behavior of the series un depends upon the value of the limit L. That is, the series un converges if the limit L is less than 1 and diverges if L is greater than 1. The test fails when L is equals to 1. The proof, it consists of three parts. One is L is less than 1. The second one is L is greater than 1. The third case is L is equals to 1. Now let us take the first part, namely L is less than 1. So case 1, let L less than 1. We know that the arithmetic mean between A and B, the two real numbers A and B, always lie between A and B, because the arithmetic mean of A and B is A plus B by 2. A plus B by 2 is the arithmetic mean between A and B. It is always lie between A and B. For example, if you take A equals to 2 and B equals to 4, then the arithmetic mean of 2 and 4, that is A and B, is 2 plus 4 by 2, that is 3. And we know that 2 is less than 3 and 3 is less than 4. That is, A is less than A plus B by 2, less than B. Therefore, by arithmetic mean, since L is less than 1, its arithmetic mean, namely L plus 1 by 2, must lie between L and 1. That is, L less than 1 implies L less than L plus 1 by 2 less than 1. Since we are given the limit of un plus 1 by un as n tends to infinity is L. This is one of the hypotheses. Limit of un plus 1 by un as n tends to infinity is L, and L is less than L plus 1 by 2 less than 1. Therefore, we are going to combine these two. When you combine these two, their x is m belongs to n, such that un plus 1 by un is less than L plus 1 by 2. Is less than L plus 1 by 2. Since we write this m belongs to n, we need not write the limit, because we are following the definition of convergent of a series. Therefore, since limit of un plus 1 by un as n tends to infinity is L, but L is less than L plus 1 by 2. Therefore, if we combine these two, we get that x is m belongs to n, such that un plus 1 by un is less than L plus 1 by 2. It is true for all n greater than or equals to m. Let us call it as 1. Now, let us choose Vn as L plus 1 by 2 whole power n. Then what is Vn plus 1 by Vn? Vn plus 1 is L plus 1 by 2 whole to the power n plus 1. Divided by, what is Vn? L plus 1 by 2 whole power n. Same factor, here we have a n plus 1, here we have n. Therefore, n get cancelled, and hence we left with only one factor, namely L plus 1 by 2. Therefore, Vn plus 1 by Vn is equals to L plus 1 by 2. This implies, or the one implies, what is 1? 1 is Un plus 1 by Un, which is less than L plus 1 by 2. Now, what is L plus 1 by 2 value? Just now we have shown that the value of L plus 1 by 2 is exactly equal to Vn plus 1 by Vn. Therefore, in equation 1, the inequality 1, we are going to replace L plus 1 by 2 by Vn plus 1 by Vn. Therefore, next step, the inequality 1 implies un plus 1 by un, which is less than vn plus 1 by vn. It is true for all n greater than or equals to m. Now, this can be written as, write the reciprocal of it, reciprocal of the above inequality, then we get un by un plus 1 is greater than Vn by Vn plus 1 for all n is greater or equal to m. We are having greater than symbol, that is the inequality is changed, because whenever we write the reciprocal of inequality, the inequality will be changed. But what is Vn? Vn is L plus 1 by 2 whole power n. Vn is L plus 1 by 2 whole power n. What is series Vn? Series L plus 1 by 2 whole power n. That is, series Vn is series L plus 1 by 2 whole power n. Now put n equal to 1, we get L plus 1 by 2. Put n equal to 2, L plus 1 by 2 whole square. Then 3, L plus 1 by 2 whole cube. That is, the series Vn is L plus 1 by 2 plus L plus 1 by 2 whole squared plus L plus 1 by 2 whole power 3 plus L plus 1 by 4, 1 by 2 whole power 4 plus L plus 1 by 2 whole power 5 plus so on. So on is an infinite series. And this series is a geometric series. This series, yeah? Geometric series. What is A here? A is the first term. What's the first term? L plus 1 by 2. What's the common ratio? Common ratio is second term divided by first term. What is second term? Put n equal to 2, we get l plus 1 by 2 whole square. That is second term. What's the first term? L plus 1 by 2. Therefore, the common ratio is second term divided by first term, that is l plus 1 by 2 whole square divided by l plus 1 by 2. Therefore, the common ratio is l plus 1 by 2. What is the value of l plus 1 by 2? L plus 1 by 2 is less than 1. Less than 1. Therefore, the series Vn is a geometric series with a common ratio less than 1. And we know that a geometric series with a common ratio less than 1 must converge. Must converge. Therefore, the series Vn is equal to series L plus 1 by 2 whole power n is a convergent geometric series with common ratio L plus 1 by 2, which is less than 1. Then by comparison test, sixth form says that series Vn also converges when L is less than 1. What is the sixth form? The sixth form of the comparison test is if series Un and series Vn are of two series of positive terms such that Un by Un plus 1 is greater than Vn by Vn plus 1 for all n is greater than or equals to m. See here, that's the one we have. Un by Un plus 1 is greater than Vn by Vn plus 1. Then series Vn is convergent if series Vn is convergent. Series Un is divergent if series Vn is divergent. Now here we have Un by Un plus 1 greater than Vn by Vn plus 1 for all n is greater than m. And the series Vn is a convergent series. Series Vn is convergent series. Therefore, the sixth form says that whenever series Vn is convergent, series Un must be convergent. Therefore, since the Vn is a convergent geometric series with common ratio less than 1, by comparison test, series Un also converges when L is 1. Thus, when L is 1, the given series is convergent. Now, case number 2. The case number 2 is, let L be greater than 1. Then again, by the arithmetic mean, we know that if A is less than B, then A is less than A plus B by 2 less than B. Since here L is greater than 1, that can be written as 1 is less than L. 1 is less than L. Then the arithmetic mean of L and 1 is 1 plus L by 2. Therefore, 1 less than L implies 1 less than L plus 1 by 2 less than L. We are given in the statement limit of un plus 1 by un as n tends to infinity is L. And now we have one inequality, that is 1 less than L plus 1 by 2 less than L. Less than L. That is L is greater than 1. L is greater than 1. Now if we combine these two, that is the limit is L, but L is greater than 1. Therefore, we can write there exists M belongs to N such that Un plus 1 by Un is L. But what is L? Greater than 1. Therefore, we have to write here greater than 1. Thus, since limit of Un plus 1 by Un as N tends to infinity is L and L is greater than 1, therefore, there exists M belongs to N such that Un plus 1 by Un is greater than 1 for all N greater than or equals to M. This implies cross multiplying, since Un is positive, every term in the series is positive. Therefore, we get un is less than un plus 1. It is true for all n is greater than or equal to m. Now, let us take the particular value n equal to m. Then, we have to replace n by m. Therefore, um is less than um plus 1 for all n is greater than or equal to m plus 1. This implies um is less than, replace m plus 1 by n here because n can take the value m plus 1. If we get um is less than un for all n is greater or equal to m plus 1. What is the series? The series is series of positive term, that is every term of the series is positive and limit of un as n tends to infinity is not equal to 0. Why? Because every term of the series is positive and the limit cannot be 0. Therefore, the series un diverges because we try to find whether the un is bounded above or not. By keeping n equal to m and n equal to m plus 1, but we cannot be able to prove that un is bounded above. So here un is not bounded above. Therefore, since series is a series of positive terms and the limit of un is not equal to 0, the series un must diverge. That is, series un diverges. Now, case 3. In case 3, let L be equals to 1. Now, we are going to show that the test fail when L equal to 1. That is, when L equal to 1, there are series whose limit equal to 1, but some series diverge, some series converge. That is, for the same limit, there are series which diverge, there are series which converge. Now we shall prove that the test fails when L is equals to 1. For this, let us consider an example of a series. Series un is equal to series 1 by n squared. Here, what is the ratio of un and un plus 1? Un plus 1 by un is 1 by n plus 1 whole square. This is un plus 1. Un is 1 by n squared, right? It's reciprocal n squared. Therefore, it is n by n plus 1 whole squared. And this divide by n. This will be 1 by 1 plus 1 by n. That is, when you take n out from the denominator, it will be n into 1 plus 1 by n. So this n get cancelled and hence we get 1 by 1 plus 1 by n whole square. So the ratio un plus 1 by un is equals to 1 by 1 plus 1 by n whole square. Let us find the limit. So limit of un plus 1 by un as n tends to infinity is limit n tends to infinity 1 by 1 plus 1 by n whole square, that is equals to, when you apply limit as n tends to infinity, this place, the place of n, we write infinity. What is 1 by infinity? 0. Therefore, it is 1 by 1 plus 0 whole square, that is 1 by 1 square, that is 1. That means the limit L is equals to 1. But what about the given series? The given series un is equal to series 1 by n squared, which is a convergent series by p-test. Why? Because this is of the form series 1 by n to the power p. What is p? What is p here? P value is 2. And we know that in the p-test, if p is greater than 1, the series convergent. If p is less than or equal to 1, the given series is divergent. Since here p value is 2, therefore by p test, the given series un equal to series 1 by n square converges. Now consider another example. Let series un equal to series 1 by n. Let us find the value of un plus 1 by un. What is un plus 1? un is 1 by n. What is un plus 1? 1 by n plus 1. What is un? 1 by n. Since un is in the denominator, write its reciprocal. Its reciprocal is n by 1. Therefore, un plus 1 by un is n by n plus 1. N by n plus 1. Take n out from the denominator, namely n plus 1. When you take n out, we get n into 1 plus 1 by n. This n and this n get cancelled, therefore 1 by 1 plus 1 by n. Find the limit. Find the limit. The limit of un plus 1 by un as n tends to infinity is equals to limit of 1 by 1 plus 1 by n, n tends to infinity. That is, n takes the value infinity, 1 by infinity is 0. Therefore, it is 1 by 1 plus 1 by infinity is 1 by 1 plus 0. That is equal to 1 by 1, that is equal to 1. What is 1? L, the limit. Because limit of un plus 1 by un is L. So here L is 1. What about the given series? The series under consideration in this case is series un equal to series 1 by n. What type of series 1 by n? Actually, it is a harmonic series. The series un is equal to series 1 by n diverges. Why diverges? Because this is of the form series 1 by n power p. What is p here? P is equals to 1. P is equals to 1. Therefore, the series un equal to series 1 by n diverges. Thus, there are two series we have considered here. Series un equal to 1 by n squared, another series 1 by n. For the both, the limit is 1. For the both series, the limit of un plus 1 by un is 1. But the first series is convergent, second series is divergent. Therefore, when n equals to 1, the series may converge or diverge. Hence, the test fails when L is equals to 1. Therefore, the statement of this theorem says that if series un is a series of positive terms and the limit of un plus 1 by un as n tends to infinity is L, then the given series un is convergent if L is less than 1 and divergent if L is greater than 1. The test fails when L is equals to 1.